Hi friends, welcome to 9.1 lecture from quantitative aptitude. Here we will discuss percentage. So what does it mean by a percentage? So in general, percent means this is per cent. Cent means 100. Okay, if for example I have a 10%, that means this means it is 10%. So for 100 its value is 10. So likewise, x percent means x by 100. Okay, very simple. So if a certain value p increased by x percent, then the increased value is. So the value is p initially. Now it is increased by x percent. So what is the value of increased value? So that will be given as 100 plus x percent of p. Very simple, because previously it was p, so now it was x percentage of, increased to x percentage of p. So previously it is simply, which is equal to 100p, 100 percentage of p, now it is x percentage of p. If I add these two, it will be like this. So similarly, if a certain value p decreases by x percent, then the decreased value is. Similarly, it will be 100 minus x percent of p. That's all. Okay, very simple concept. Let's move on to the next formula. If the price of a commodity, so this is the commodity type of problem, if the price of a commodity increases by r percent, then the reduction in consumption so as not to increase the expenditure is. So how to deal with it? This will be equal to r divided by 100 plus r into 100. This is the formula. So what does it mean? For example, if the price of a commodity increases by r percent, so I have a sugar, okay, its value is 1 kg, its value is 100 rupees, for example. Now its value has been increased to 10%, so it will become 110 rupees now for 1 kg. But now what exactly happens? I am ready to reduce my consumption so as not to increase the expenditure. So I don't like to put 110 rupees here. I want to put 100 rupees only. But now how much will I get? So how much will I get? So let me solve this. You just see. So r means, it is here, r is 10%, so 10 divided by 110 into 100 percentage. So this much I need to reduce, my consumption. So let me, if you can do this, you will get 100 by 11%. Okay, so in this way we need to move forward. So same thing in the opposite fashion. For example, if the cost has been reduced by r percent, so what may be the increase in the consumption? So that will be equal to r divided by 100 minus r into 100 percent, simply. Okay, so these are the commodity type of problems. Let's move on to the next formula. Let the population of a town be p now, and suppose it increases at the rate of r percent, then per annum, then population of after n years will be. So these are coming under population type of problems. Yes, now population after 100 years, so I mean after n years, how much it will be? So p is the initial population, and now after n years, there should be increase in population at the rate of r% every year. So it should be p into 1 plus r by 100 whole power n. Similarly, population n years ago will be p divided by 1 plus r by 100 whole power n. So these are the population type of problem. Let's move on to the next formula. Let the present value of a machine be P. Suppose it depreciates. So these are the depreciation type of problems. At a rate of r% per annum, then the value of machine after n years will be. So the formula is same, just like population, but for population it increases. For this, it will be reduced. So, P into 1 minus R by 100 whole power N. Similarly, this would be P divided by 1 minus R by 100 whole power N. Let's move on to the next formula. This is the last formula. So, if A is r% more than B, then B is less than A by r by r by 100 plus r into 100%. Similarly, if A is r% less than B, then B is more than A by r by 100 minus r into 100%. That's all. So these are the formulae used for the calculating the percentage type of problems. So these are very simple. So hardly I have one, two, maximum three type of problems. Even though they are six, I can convert them into three type of problems. So on a whole, we can explain these things in a very short manner. If certain value P has been increased by x%, then what is the value of increased value? So the increased value is, it is x%. So previous value is P. So this should be in term, we need to write in terms of percentage. So P means it is 100%. Now it is increased to x%. So it means 100 is the previous value and it is increased to x% now. So it is in percentage of P simply. So this is one formula. Now coming to commodity formula. So commodity means if rate is increased by r%. So what is the reduction in consumption? Okay, if that is the case, the formula will be R divided by 100 plus R into 100%. That's all. Okay, and for example, if a commodity decreases by r%, so how much it will be? What is the increase in the consumption? In that case, it will be minus. So let me show you. In that case, it will be minus. So same formula can be repeated for more. For example, if A is more than B, so B is less than A by plus times. Okay. And if it is less and more, for example, if it is A is less than B, so how much B is more than A, then it will be minus. Okay, simply. Next, coming to population and depreciation. So population means it will be improved after N years. Depreciation means it will be reduced after N years. So simply, for population, the value, the formula will be P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power n. For population, after n years. For population, n years ago means p by 1 plus r by 100 whole power n. Similarly, for depreciation, same type of formula, but over the years it will be reduced. So 1 minus r by 100 whole power n, and p divided by 1 minus r by 100 whole power n. That's all. Very simple. So here the commodity means, if it is price is increased by r percent, so plus will come. If it is reduced by r percent, minus will come. Okay, so please see the color coding. Even here also it will be more. If A is more than B, then how much B is less than A, that will be in plus. So if it is green, if it is less and more, then it will be minus. The same thing will be here. Okay, so if you can remember these three formulae, it's sufficient. So you can make up with one. If you know one thing, you can go ahead with another thing. Okay, it's very easy. So please try to remember these formulae so that we can move forward. And I have already created the Google form for the quiz 9, and I will post with this as the description of this video. So please try to solve that, and in the tomorrow's class we will try to solve those problems from quiz 9. Okay, thank you so much for your careful listening and continuous following. And please try to like this video, share this video with your friends and family, and kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't done so. And please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. Thank you so much.